Hey, what's going on, guys? So today I'm going to show you a quick and easy way to add wireless charging to almost any smartphone. So here we go. All right, guys. So first of all, if you like technical reviews and tutorials, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and then hit the little bell next to it. That'll notify you when I put up a new one of these videos. So this one's going to talk about wireless charging and adding it to pretty much any smartphone. So I had a smartphone a few phones ago that had wireless charging built in, and I really, really got used to that. Not having to deal with the cables, fumbling with them in the middle of the night, and just being able to throw it down on the charger was a big plus in my book. But a lot of the phones that I've gotten since then didn't have it. So I found two ways that we're going to look at is, like, I have on my Axon 7 here that is it uses a charging pad that plugs into the port at the bottom, and they have these for USB Type-C, they have them for micro USB, they have them for Thunderbolt. And then on the iPhone, we also are going to look at another option, which is a case that has the wireless charging built in. And it's the same concept that plugs in at the bottom, but it's nicely in a case, and it just works and looks a little nicer. So let's get into the one with the case first. So this is just a standard iPhone 6s Plus, and it has the Thunderbolt port at the bottom. And I looked around for, you know, kind of the pads, but I came across a case. There's a few of these out there. This one's from Bezalel, and I may have butchered that name. I apologize if I did. And the reason why I went with this case is because it has the cable at the bottom pulls out a little bit. So you can easily remove that when you have the case on and you want to use the port. It's not so snug that you can't pull it out and use that charging port when you need to sync to the computer, or if you just want to charge in your car and you don't have wireless charging in there. So this is all in one in a case. It's a nice neoprene kind of case, and it just has the connector at the bottom. So the phone just goes in as it does with any other case. And then at the bottom, you slide the connector in there, and then you're good to go. You slap it down on your wireless charger then, and it immediately starts charging. It's flush with the bottom of the case. It's a nice fit. So they don't just have the cases for iPhones, they also have them for Android phones. But there's such a wide gamut of Android phones that you might have trouble finding that. So you may have to look at the next option. So the next option is similar to the first, except it's a pad that goes into whatever case, or if you have a phone with a removable back, you can just slide it into that removable back, have the real thin cable come out the bottom, and plug it into the bottom. You have it all self-contained. This Axon 7 that I'm using now, it does not have a removable back. So what I did was I just stuck it into my case where it has a little bit of slack at the bottom, because I want to be able to get access to that port. So you kind of have to maneuver these a little more. It's a little more difficult, but you can get these in, put it right under the case, and then you have the same kind of setup as you have with the built-in case. It doesn't look as pretty because it's a clear case, but if you had a colored case or a black case or something like that, you wouldn't even see that, and it doesn't add hardly any bump to it at all. So again, they have these for USB Type-C, micro USB, Thunderbolt, pretty much any connection that you have at the bottom. And you just put it in there and then throw it down on the charger, and you're good to charge. It does charge much slower than it does with the cable that came with your phone, so keep that in mind. But I usually throw it on when I go to sleep, and when I wake up in the morning, it's at 100%. So it works for me. So the last thing that we're going to talk about is the charging pads. So these are both generic pads that I got. I got this one on Amazon. I'll have a link down in the description. And then this one, these things used to be kind of hard to find, but I actually got this in the grocery store for $5 a few weeks ago. And I don't have a link in the description to this one because I got it in the grocery store. But this one works just as well as this. It does charge a little bit slower, but I keep this one on my desk at work. And I just have my phone on there when I'm at work. And this one's on my nightstand at home. And when I go to bed, I just throw it in there. I don't have to fumble with the cable or anything. And it works just as well with the built-in Qi charging, which is the wireless charging, the case on the iPhone, or the card that I added aftermarket onto the Axon 7. So that's it, guys. It's relatively cheap and easy to add wireless charging to any smartphone and not have to deal with those cables, but then you can still unplug it and use the cable if you need to hook to the computer, charge in your car, whatever you need that port for. So I hope you guys found this informative and useful. Please, again, hit that subscribe button, leave some comments below, give me a thumbs up if you liked the video, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Thanks so much.